We shall now be studying four experiments which will help us to understand what is electromagnetic induction. Let us start with the very first one. In this, you have got two stands, and from the stands, we have suspended a conducting wire. The two other ends, free ends of the wire, are connected to the two terminals of the galvanometer. Now, exactly below the wire, we have placed a bar magnet such that either of the two poles, that is north or south, is present just below the wire. So this kind of an arrangement we have done. Keep the bar magnet erect, that is straight, in such a way that its north or south pole is just below the copper wire. Now, if the wire is kept moving from A, B, the pointer of the galvanometer gets deflected. Now, what we find is that if we start moving this wire, this position is A position of the wire, and we are setting the wire in motion by taking it towards point B. The dotted line here is the position B of the wire. We observe deflection in the galvanometer needle or pointer. Again, when you bring the wire back to position A, again you see deflection in the galvanometer needle, but it is exactly opposite to what it had taken place in the earlier case when you had taken the wire to point B. Say, for example, when we take the wire to position B, the galvanometer needle, which was initially at zero, shows us deflection towards the left. And then it again comes back to zero. When you bring the wire back to position A, you find that the galvanometer pointer now deflects towards the right and again comes back to zero. So this deflection in the galvanometer pointer indicates that there is current which has been induced in the wire. Now, we are not using any other source of energy, that is cell or battery. Still, we find that the current is getting induced, which is being indicated by the galvanometer needle deflection. So where is this current coming from? So when we are moving this wire, there is a magnetic field around this magnet. And when we are moving this wire, the magnetic field associated with this magnet is changing. And so a changing magnetic field is inducing current into the wire. So this is how the current is getting induced into the wire. Now, in the second part of the experiment, we will keep the wire constant, and instead we will start moving the bar magnet. The wire is constant, but now we are moving the magnet. We take it to this position, again get it back. And we constantly do this. So long as we are moving the bar magnet, we find that the galvanometer pointer shows us deflection. So with this, we come to the conclusion that if the wire is moving and the magnet is constant, or the magnet is moving and the wire is constant, in either case, we see deflection in the galvanometer needle, which indicates that a current is induced in the wire. If you are keeping the wire and the bar magnet stationary, if they are not moving, you find that the needle is at zero, which means that there is no current which is induced. So what Michael Faraday said was that a current will be induced only if there is relative motion between the wire and the magnet. So either of the two have to be in motion. So long as they are in motion, we find that the current is induced. If the motion is stopped, then the current is not going to be induced in the wire. Another thing that you need to observe is the faster the motion of the wire, the greater is the current that is induced. If you are even moving the bar magnet very fast, you will find that the deflection in the pointer is very fast. If you are moving the magnet very slowly, then the magnetic field associated with it is also going to change very less, and so the current that will be induced will also be less. So the faster the motion, the greater is the current that is induced. So this is called as Faraday's electromagnetic induction. Now move the magnet with the wire fixed. So this is also what we have already seen. The galvanometer pointer still gets deflected. So this is what is electromagnetic induction. And what we conclude from this experiment is that what Faraday observed was that the current that is going to flow through this wire will be induced. The current will be induced in this wire only if there is relative motion between the wire and the bar magnet. And the direction of the deflection, the direction of the deflection in the galvanometer needle is going to get reversed if the direction of motion is going to be reversed. So if we are going to reverse the direction of motion, we find that the direction of the current is going to get reversed, and hence the deflection in the galvanometer needle is also reversed. So this is the first experiment that we studied with respect to electromagnetic induction. Let us take up one more example to understand electromagnetic induction. For this, we need a solenoid coil. The two ends of the solenoid coil are connected to a battery and a key, plug key. Now, very close to this solenoid coil, we have placed another coil, and the two ends of this coil are connected to a galvanometer. In this experiment, if we open the plug key, so this is the plug key. Right now it is open because there is no dot, so it's an open key. If we open the plug key and make the current zero in the coil, the pointer of the galvanometer deflects to a side and quickly comes back to zero. If the current in the coil is started again, the pointer again deflects to the other side and then returns quickly to zero. Now, let us see why this is happening. You are passing current through the solenoid coil. Due to the passing of the current through the solenoid coil, it develops a uniform magnetic field inside it. Now, suppose suddenly you remove the plug key from here. The moment you remove the plug key, you observe deflection in the galvanometer needle here, which indicates that a current has been induced into this coil. Now that you have removed the key, you momentarily see the deflection in the galvanometer pointer. Say, for example, the pointer has shifted to left, and then it again comes back to zero and becomes stationary. You do not see any more deflection. Now you put the key on again. Once again, you will see that as soon as you put the key on, the galvanometer needle shows you deflection. But now it is in the opposite direction, that is towards the right side, which indicates that again the current has been induced into this coil. Now that the key is still on and the current is flowing through the solenoid coil and there is a uniform magnetic field that is developed, but you do not see any more deflection in the galvanometer needle. It just moved once towards the right and again it has come back to zero. So why is it that only when we are plugging the key in or we are plugging the key out that we see the deflection in the galvanometer needle? Let us try to understand the reason behind it. When current is flowing through the solenoid coil, a uniform magnetic field is developed. But to induce current into this coil, we need a changing magnetic field. This changing magnetic field will be produced only when we plug the key in or we plug the key out. If we put the key in, the magnetic field associated with the solenoid coil changes and it induces current into the coil. When we plug the key out, again the magnetic field associated with the solenoid coil changes and it introduces current into this coil or induces current into this coil, and we can see the deflection in the galvanometer needle. So this is also what we refer it to as electromagnetic induction, and this was observed by Faraday. So whenever the number of magnetic lines of force passing through the coil change, it induces current into the coil. And this happens only when we plug the key in and out. In the earlier experiment, we saw that there has to be relative motion between the coil and the magnet. If either of the two are moving, it induces a changing magnetic field. In this experiment, what have we studied? That to produce a changing magnetic field, we constantly need to put the plug key on and off so as to induce current into this coil. So this is the second experiment which helps us to understand electromagnetic induction.